One claims it's the company's only chance for survival.
Atari has filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection. The 31-year-old
EWA presents the difference between
Kodak is filing for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection.
What's up, guys? My name is Jake, and welcome to the fourth episode of Bankrupt. This episode is brought to you by Audible. Go to audible.com/BSF or text BSF to 500-500 to get a 30-day free trial, a credit for an audiobook of your choice, plus two Audible originals. Iceland has been a place I've wanted to visit for a while now. I've been planning and pricing out a journey there for over a year, and choosing one particular airline flying nonstop routes from Toronto for extremely competitive prices. It sounded like a pretty good deal to me. It was only a few months later, though, that I saw in the news that the entire airline abruptly filed for bankruptcy and ceased all operations, canceling all flights just minutes before they were scheduled to take off. So let's discover how this relatively unprecedented airline bankruptcy happened, and take a look at WOW Air. So WOW Air was founded in November of 2011 by an Icelandic entrepreneur, Skúli Mogensen. He founded the company to follow the popular budget airline business model. This type of market has been well fleshed out in areas like the United States and Europe. So WOW Air was to present itself as a new player in this market, serving almost exclusively flights to Iceland. Mogensen had secured funding for his brand new company via an internal investment firm that he owned and took majority ownership of the private airline and became CEO. While it was a risky move to start an airline, especially a budget one, in such a fierce and competitive market, flying out of Iceland with this plan actually seemed to be quite smart. The only other major airline that services Iceland is Iceland Air, which for over 70 years had dominated that specific market, setting their own fares. Now with WOW Air on the scene, they brought extremely competitive prices, in some cases charging $200 or $300 less than Iceland Air, making WOW the obvious choice for any budget-conscious traveler. So by 2012, the company began its first flights from Iceland to Paris, London, and Copenhagen via their two leased Airbus A320s. Despite the investments in the airline, the company was still extremely small, with just a headquarters and a small office and having only 70 employees on payroll. However, by 2013, things began to grow. The company had applied for their own air operator certificate to allow them to operate their own aircraft for commercial purposes. WOW Air now had three aircraft transporting more than 400,000 people annually, a pretty impressive increase from their zero just 2 years prior. This level of growth continued for the next several years, allowing WOW Air to carry its millionth passenger by late 2014. The airline grew more and more over the next few months, harshly competing with Iceland Air and looking for new and profitable routes to expand their reach. In 2015, the company announced they would begin routes to Iceland from America, the first two cities being Boston and Washington, D.C. This came at a pretty good time, too, as more Americans were beginning to travel to Iceland as the country was becoming a hot travel destination. Hot being figurative, it's relatively very cold there. WOW Air quickly became the most affordable way to travel to Iceland from Europe and the United States, also eventually offering routes from Canada in 2016. This prompted the airline to purchase two brand new Airbus A321s to offer non-Iceland destinations across the Atlantic. Over 280 people worked for the company now, and they began expanding their routes even further to now offer long-haul routes all the way to Los Angeles and San Francisco with their three newly leased A330-300 aircraft. And as 2016 came in, WOW Air grew at a rate unlike before. The airline became very well known for their bold aircraft liveries and pretty good customer satisfaction, but mostly for their insane pricing strategy. For instance, if you were to fly from New York's Newark Airport to Reykjavik, Iceland, a nonstop flight with WOW Air would cost you around $110. Of course, there's a bunch of additional fees alongside, but as a base fare, that's what it would cost. As a comparison, a similar flight on Iceland Air would cost you around $320. So obviously WOW had the upper hand on the market pricing. However, that too came at a cost. By 2017, the airline's popularity and growth exploded. WOW Air was now carrying more than 2.8 million passengers a year, with its now 12 aircraft. The airline expanded to Asia as well, now becoming a more major airline and almost surpassing Iceland Air in size. WOW had also just hired their 1,000th employee and placed leasing orders for brand new aircraft at Airbus. By the end of 2017, the company had earned $486 million in total revenue, yet had a staggering total loss of around $27.5 million. Despite their growth, the low margins and external expenses like fuel had laid a huge loss on the company. However, determined to keep going, the company and Mogensen still were confident in the airline. The company saw even more growth during the following year, now carrying 3.5 million passengers. They also won the award for the best low-cost airline of the year from the CAPA. However, while things looked pretty good on the outside, internally, the airline was in trouble. The burden of running an airline, especially a budget carrier, began to weigh in on the growing company. More planes means more fuel, maintenance, landing fees, and passengers to deal with. More employees means more wages, benefits, training, and so on. These immense expenses were piling up, so the company decided to slash their operating costs by canceling routes and removing almost half of their fleet to just 11 planes. However, even the Iceland market itself wasn't doing all that well during this time, with even Iceland Air losing money. Because remember, this is a country of just 300,000 people, which is less than the population of Wyoming, so the bulk of air traffic in will be tourists. However, with the population being that small and tourists really only coming in the summer months, two large airlines can't really survive in that. WOW Air ended 2018 with just a $6 million loss, and with high hopes they would end 2019 with better or actually any profit. However, things were not looking good for the company. Earlier in the year, they were in talks of Iceland Air buying them out entirely. However, that never happened. Soon after though, Indigo Partners, an investment company which also has stakes in other low-cost carriers, had reached a tentative agreement to purchase WOW as they were running out of money and needed someone to step in and give them long-term investment. Soon after, the airline announced they would be cutting their workforce by 360 people, and another 5 aircraft were to be sold off. The orders that they had placed for Airbus's A330neos had also been cancelled, furthermore basically cancelling all of their long-haul routes. By January 2019, the airline announced the Indigo Partners deal would allow them to take up to 49% of the airline, with an option to increase later. Just 2 months later though, Indigo had pulled out from the deal, and WOW was left with no financial backing and a crippled company, very quickly running out of money. As a last-ditch effort, they tried to reopen their purchase deal with Iceland Air, but after the legacy airline looked over their numbers, they said they weren't interested. With no external company willing to put up money or buy out the entire company, WOW Air had begun canceling flights. And just a few days later, on March 28th, 2019, the entire company began to collapse. Unbelievably, WOW Air had suddenly and abruptly ceased all operations and cancelled all flights on the same day. In some cases, flights were just hours and minutes away from taking off when the news came in that the company had declared bankruptcy, and all remaining flights would be cancelled. This left thousands of passengers stranded across the world with no money able to be refunded, which most needed to pay out via travel insurance. Pretty much all of the stranded passengers had no idea that WOW was even in trouble, let alone literally hours away from Chapter 7 bankruptcy. From the consumer side, I think the airline did a marvelous job at appearing not to have any problems. Honestly, their quirky approach to an airline was quite interesting and a little funny. I think they did a great job at presenting themselves as something bigger than they actually were. But on the inside, the airline, I would imagine for its entire life really, had some sort of financial issues. And there were multiple reasons as to why. Some I mentioned earlier with the general operating costs of an airline, which the revenue from extremely low fares did not help. Consumer confidence in the airline began to slip towards the end as well, and the fact that the general location of operations wasn't really sustainable, as tourism is only big in Iceland during the summer months, and the off-season severely hurt the company's profits. Even just a few months prior, another budget airline, which also originated out of Iceland, Primera Air, had also declared bankruptcy and left passengers in a similar situation. So now, WOW Air is nothing more than just another failed budget airline, as their assets are now slowly sold off, and the company turns to nothing but a domain name. Their bold aircraft now sit unused in airports across the world, awaiting their unknown future. The company's former CEO, and I'm not kidding, is looking to bring back the crippled company in a sort of WOW Air 2.0. He says he would just buy back the assets from the bankrupt company and package them into a new airline, which he says would learn from his previous endeavor. All he needs is around $40 million to relaunch the company with a now slow-growth business plan and a fleet of 5 brand new Airbus A321neos. Will he get the funding he needs to restart the company? No, probably not. The previous track record for the brand is not very good, and leaving thousands of travelers stranded with no refunds and ways to get home isn't really a good way to get the public excited for your revived airline. But who knows, maybe I'm wrong. That's really something that only time will tell. But for now, on the former airline's website, it reads at the bottom of their corporate timeline, "The future is WOW." So I guess that means I'm not going on that Iceland vacation then. However, if I did, I would probably be terrified considering I don't like flying and the route from Toronto to Iceland is over 5 hours long. So I would need to keep my mind occupied, and the best way I can think to do that is with Audible. You can listen to an unmatched selection of audiobooks on any devices, like Malaysian Airlines Flight 370, Why It Disappeared, wait, that's absolutely not what you want to listen to on a plane, like the Southwest Airlines Way, a book that demonstrates how the American budget airline continued to profit for 31 years, where other budget airlines like WOW couldn't. But if airline economics aren't your thing, there are a ton of other selections out there to provoke and inspire. With an Audible subscription, you can choose 3 titles every month, 1 audiobook, and 2 Audible originals. It's a great deal, and I'm not kidding, it is very helpful on a flight. If you use the link audible.com/BSF or text BSF to 500-500, you will get a 30-day free trial, a credit for any priced audiobook on Audible, plus 2 free Audible originals, all of which you get to keep forever even if you don't keep your membership. My name is Jake, and thank you very much for watching.